something that the group decided not to include? In something that was in the individual reports, perhaps, that you decided that you needed to leave out when you did the team presentation?
Personally, when I was doing my own report, I had a lot of statistics and quotes from different like government organizations or environmental organizations that described the problem. I felt that a lot, and I wanted to put a lot of that in, but I felt like we would run out of time. Mm-hmm. And I knew that there are like much shorter ways of describing the problem that wouldn't require so much information.
Okay. All right, great. Ting Yi, can you reflect on the group norms that you guys established and maybe think about something that you might do differently next time?
I think one of our group norms that we decided on was that we were going to be in touch and communicate with each other. On a regular basis, that didn't really happen. Mm-hmm. We do have a running Google Doc for both our individual reports and this presentation where we sort of gave each other a rough idea of what we were actually about to say. But it was kind of messy and each of us didn't really finalize our own bit in that Google Doc. So like today, this is like the first time we ran through this presentation. We had no idea, but we were like, oh, you're gonna do the slide? No, I didn't know I was gonna do the slide. And then we were like freaking out at the last minute, but yeah.
Okay. And then Philip. Mm-hmm. What was something that you read? That's okay. What was something that you read in somebody else's individual report that impacted you?
Well, I feel like that our articles were kind of about the same thing, but when I was reading, I didn't get to read a lot of Ting Yi's, to be honest, because we only got to read each other's reports pretty late in. But when Madeline's the one I got to read the most, and when I was reading it, I noticed the question was, sorry, can you repeat the question? I can't remember.
Whose report impacted you the most and why?
Takeaway?
Well, to be honest, it wasn't actually the content of it, but it was how Madeline wrote her actual paper. It was a lot more, because when I write my papers, they're not very organized to say. So when I saw Madeline's, I liked how her style was a lot more organized. She listed all her facts and details very clearly. And so I kind of took that away for like, you know, that I should, how to better organize my content papers, especially for the presentation itself.
Okay, super, thank you. All right, give them a round.